What's going on, everybody? It's Childish. We're back at it again, coming at you with another video for Summoner's War. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at our newest LD toy in the game, the Lightstream Master Dong Back. So before we get into the video, though, can I take a quick second to give you guys a lot of praise here? I don't know if you know, but 3 days ago, we put out a video basically how to build a triple crown, triple crown team, okay? How to basically create a 30-second Kyber's dungeon team using 5 units for all 3 dungeons here. And to my surprise, after the first day, getting maybe about 5,000 views, something happened. Basically, you guys decided to like the video, share it with your friends, your guildies, your classmates, whatever the case may be, and it somehow grew up into 25,000 views over the last, basically over the weekend here. So again, something like this generally doesn't happen when it comes to the algorithm after the second or third day. So I basically know that it was you guys, the viewers, that really enjoyed the content and started sharing with everybody, and people got wind of it and they're enjoying it. So again, guys, if you like that kind of style of video, okay, please feel free to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and I will definitely make an effort to bring some more of that type of video, okay? So let's go ahead and get into this, okay? Dong Back Light String Master. When I first pulled it, I was super hyped, but then I talked to the community. They're like, oh, I don't know how good it is. I'm like, okay, whatever. I'm just going to roll with it because it's a new toy, right? So let's look at a kit here. Flower Blooming Song, okay? We got an ability here. It's going to have basically a 75% chance to provide a glancing hit when you get this skill maxed out. The next skill, Melody of Resentment. This is the bread and butter of this unit. Basically plays a song that decreases the HP of the enemy by 5% and the attack power for one turn with a 50% chance that can improve up to a 65% chance here. And again, you cannot attack with this unit together or counterattack while playing this song. It can go to a two turn cooldown, which is actually pretty important, if I may say so. And this one combined alongside the passive, being able to essentially keep your attack bar reducing while the song is playing and increasing the attack bar while the song is not playing and the enemies are getting the turn here, is really, really nice, because basically you don't have to really be focused on speed for this one. You'll get that attack bar increase when the song's not playing and the opponents are taking a turn. In addition to that, once you get that song playing, combine the attack bar reduction with the low amount of speed here and the fact that speed is king, and everybody runes up their units with, you know, plus 100, plus 150, plus 200 speed, they're going to be constantly lapping you, potentially taking violent procs here. So this is going to give you more opportunities to proc that 5% heal. So when I first took a look at this unit, I ain't going to lie, I was like, you know, how is this really going to fit in the meta? How is this going to go ahead and, you know, really tackle some of the units that we see here? So what I thought about doing is bringing up some of the basically yellow comps that I would think people would, you know, essentially use this one for here. You know, yellow based comps that we see in like nat 4 siege defenses or whatnot, or nat 5 siege defenses here, that potentially could take advantage of the attack break as well as the hit point reduction here. But again, it was kind of, like I said, it was really, really weird for me, because I'm like, we're literally focused on yellow comps here. There's no HP or bruiser comp that you're going to be like, hey, 5% HP, like this is going to be beneficial. Or there's no real, you know, defense scaling units out there in the meta right now that people are utilizing a defense outside of like Feng Yang, maybe, that I could think of off the top of my head that's really going to be beneficial. Again, Feng has his own little way of healing. Like I said, this is one of those weird units that I just really don't know how it's going to fit. But either way, guys, ruining this one, this was outrageously hard to rune for me. Why is that? Because the focus is to get it as efficient as possible. You want the HP, you want the, you know, defense, you want to be as tanky as possible, and you want to have as much resistance as possible, right? Because again, the goal is to play the song and let that song play as long as possible. But again, if you get locked down by anything, right? If you get reset, if you get control with CC, any kind of inability effect here, it doesn't allow you to play a song, and therefore it doesn't allow you to do what she's trying to do here. So my goal basically was to get as much HP defense as possible, a little to no speed as possible, with as much resistance as possible. And as you guys can see, this was very, very hard, because we just don't keep runes with high resistance that also have literally no speed here. I mean, and if there are any kind of runes like that, Leo may have it, but again, resistance, yeah, like whatever, right? Whatever. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and jump into some test matches here. Go ahead and give this one a whirl. Again, I don't really know how this is gonna work and what they're gonna do here, but is it too soon to say maybe this needs a little boost? Like the 5% HP is like, it's just not doing it for me right now. So we'll just have to see. I'm plussing out the first impression. Maybe I should just go ahead and test it. Okay, so these are the two defenses that we're gonna test it in. We're just going to go ahead and we'll do them one at a time, because obviously we cannot play both at the same time here. And what I'm going to do, I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to stack. I'm going to have some fun. We'll have some fun here with an LD, some more LD toys. Most of you guys don't even know I have this here. Falaria. Okay, Valeria, I forget. I ain't even gonna lie. What is it? Dryad, right? That's why I don't know this yet. I don't know this unit. Light Dryad, right? So Valeria, Light Dryad, pretty cool kit, right? Passive, being able to recover the HP granted with the harmful effect by 50% turn, and then if they have no harmful effects, we get a shield equivalent to 15% of the HP. So my goal basically is to use her as to provide a little bit of support and safety, and then what we'll go ahead and do is we'll bring in. Let's go ahead and bring in. Can we bring in a unit? Well, we're bringing Amelia. Okay, we'll run Amelia in this one. And essentially, we're just like, it's almost like we can go auto in this and like let these guys kill themselves, right? So that's what we're gonna try here. Okay, and I'm just gonna click on some units here because obviously we don't really care about that. We're just gonna run it and see how lucky we can get here. I mean, I would love to go auto on this, but I can't because of the fact that Amelia, I mean, any unicorn on auto is just not a good thing, right? Okay, so here we go. Let's go ahead and oh, we could play the song. Yeah, we can. Okay, so let's do that, right? Play it. Oh, we gotta play a song on ourselves. Hey, so you can't click it on somebody else, okay? Just in case you guys were wondering, you have to click it on yourself. I try to click it on the opponent. Good game. Epic fails here. Again, as you guys can see, this is the first attempt that we do. So yeah, rip the dream here. So again, okay. We don't really have any harmful effects to transfer, right? Because we're doing this. So let's just I guess we'll just keep on bringing this unit down a little bit here. Right. Oh, here we go. Now we got some stuff to transfer. Can we get a freeze on this one? No freeze. It's all good. Say hey. Oh. Hey, hold on a minute. Wait a minute. Let's go ahead and transfer this. Okay. Let's do that. Amelia, can we go ahead again? I want to go ahead and stun this one. I don't want that attack buff. Oh my gosh. You're kidding me right now. This is bad. Okay. Well, that's good. That's good. That's good. Because now she's focused on Amelia, so she's not gonna rip up my Valeria. Right. Okay. Go ahead and do this damage. Again. I want to see this guy. Like the cool thing about this is that essentially I don't even think yeah, that's crazy. Dongbaek hasn't even like she hasn't even gotten out of her song. She's continuously been staying in the song, which is really, really good, right? So let's go ahead and keep on bringing this down. Let's do this one here again. Yeah, they're bringing it down here. So and I guess the best part about this is that like this works really good against Yen, right? Because Yang has the opportunity to proc additional turns, so we're constantly getting that attack bar reduction here. That's interesting. That's interesting. Okay. Let's do this. I feel like maybe we should work on Clara, right? She's the one that gets stripped. We don't want to get in trouble. But again, once their damage dealer is down, it's just a matter of time to get this one cleared out here. So let's go ahead and do that. Yep. Oh, by the way, I don't know if you guys saw. I got like 53% crit rate on this one. Yeah, buddy. That's what I'm talking about. The main thing to focus, right? Not. I just happen to have runes ahead. We're gonna critical rate on it. So I was like, okay, sounds good. Let's see here. All right, should we use this skill? All allies will recover by 20%. So for all of you guys that give me a hard time, okay, that is like childish. Why haven't you been healing with the second skill when you don't have any harmful effect? What's the matter? Hey, just give me a breather. This is obviously the first time I use this unit in like a long time, okay? Obviously. So hey, we figured it out though. We can heal with this one. All right. So this is now the thing that's going on in my head right now, because obviously we tackle this one. Let's just go ahead and auto it out, right? We don't really care right now. But what I'm trying to think of is. When somebody pulls this unit, Dongbaek, obviously no one's going to have Valeria. Not everybody's going to have Amelia. And the majority of the units that we're probably going to attack are going to be stuff that we're going to see in like Nat 4 Siege Defense. So what are the comps that you can incorporate that would work? And so, I mean, obviously, if we're looking at some kind of unit that has that passive, shield or whatnot here, Kamoon's always an option, but a lot of people have a good amount of Kamoons here. Or potentially... what's another unit that we can use? Maybe on the offensive side, maybe something like Raccoonie, whereas Raccoonie essentially helps us out when we're in need, if we need to get that song in there and played, but it also provides a little bit of heal, a little bit of research for your Kamoon. So maybe like I said, the Kamoon Dong and Raccoonie, something like that, or Kamoon Dong. Triana, but then again, Triana, maybe not Triana because of the fact that we're going up against a composition that we're going to be looking at right now, where we have the CR Lauren Roque, that opportunity to get additional attacks and basically bypass Triana's passive might not be the way to go here. So, okay, let's go ahead and test it out once again. Let's go ahead and slap this one on here. And should we just go ahead? We'll test it out here. Let's do something else. What could we do? What could we throw in here? Oh, you know what, dude? Let's have some fun. I don't know if this is gonna work, but let's have some fun. All right, so you guys already know what I'm gonna do, right? This is the one thing that Sean B showed me back in the day, where we busted out this Nat 4 here. There we go, Guillaume, whatever it is. We'll go ahead and run. What do we got? We got accuracy. You know what? Can we run? You know, let's go ahead and we'll just run the we'll just run a defense here. No, wait. Attack bar. We want the attack bar increase, right? Okay, let's do that. So again, we're gonna pick random units here. We're just gonna click and not all the monsters have runes. Obviously, I don't have any runes on Guillaume, but we'll go ahead and exit this out, move on to the next one, and see what happens here. Okay, so everything is working as planned, right? But the question is, how long is this going to work, right? How long is this going to work? Let's see here. Now, again, what wait a minute. Oh, this is what I now I get it. So Ciara literally has not hold on. We'll transfer all the harmful effects granted on ally. Okay, so I'm reading the stuff here. Okay, we cannot do wait. No, hold on. We can, right? No. We can. Yeah, we can. This will work. Because we still got Lauren's gonna go. She's gonna put a defense break on, and we're good, right? Okay, I think this is gonna work. I think it's gonna work. Okay, hold on. We're gonna do this here. Put it on Rogue. Okay. But yeah, this is gonna work, right? This is gonna work. Wait a minute. We need the defense break on it. Oh, it's not gonna work no more. No. Okay, that's unfortunate here, but this is what we do. Just for the sake of the video, we're gonna go ahead out of the rest of it out. We're gonna see how long this will work here. Again, as you guys can see, the decrease in the attack bar is still coming in, but we got a little bit of a concern. Compliments of CR here. CR again can provide that bomb, stun it, control it. So this is gonna be a pain in the butt if we lose this unit. Oh my goodness! Come on, hey, can you get a turn? Can you get one turn? No, you're not gonna get a turn. All right, rip the dream here. So funny enough, will this work? 1v3, okay. Foxy's like, oh my gosh, dude, if this works, I'm definitely gonna put it in one of my videos. It doesn't look like it's gonna work here. Yeah, it doesn't look like it's gonna work. Rip the dream. But again, like I said before, it's an interesting kit, right? Like I said, you only can bring it up. I feel like you can only utilize it in certain YOLO comps because again, HP scaling, defense scaling units, you know, bruisers essentially. You're just not going to get a lot of value out of it. They're going to be too tanky. They're obviously probably going to be synergized with units, going to be able to keep them alive. Whereas YOLO, they're literally going in, trying to get a kill, you know, quick kill here. And if you do great, if not, then you're just going to be able to, you know, beat them down by means of attrition on this skill. So, let me know what you guys are thinking about on this unit. Again, I even talked to some of my friends on the side. I've talked to some of my guildies. So I'm like honestly, like I'm excited for the new unit, but I'm like, man, like I want to make an argument to like mess around with this in like a, you know, Nat 4 siege defense, but I feel like. I don't think it's gonna work. I feel like it's gonna be an opportunity to use versus certain compositions, and on the offensive side, and maybe we'll get away with it. Like again, another comp that we could throw out there, Kamun or Ryan Miho, very very common, you know, strategy to do. And then of course now people are running not Vampire Miho, but they're running Violent Miho. So you know maybe Violent Miho will be proccing like crazy, be doing it. But again, the whole Kamun providing the shield, after we're getting the attack break and the HP reduction on the units here, it's like. You're going to be able to protect, you know, a little bit here. It's going to be going back and forth here. So I don't know how valuable this is. Let me know what you guys think about this unit, the current state of it. Is this something that is viable? Am I missing something? Do you feel like this may need a little bit more love here? Maybe a little bit higher attack, maybe a little bit higher heal break. Or sorry, heal break. Maybe a little bit higher heal loss, right? Maybe something like 10 or 50% per turn, or maybe something like some additional harmful effects that could be put on there, like, almost like an Orion, like you put an attack break with a defense, or, you know, something to give it a reason for your units to focus on it, maybe on like a defensive side. I'd be curious to see what your guys' feedback on that. Again, I'm just going off my head, but again, I feel like there could be a little bit more done in this one. But I'm gonna go ahead and leave it at that, guys. Once again, I want to give you guys a huge shout out for whatever it is that you did to go ahead and showcase the video. And if you haven't seen it enough on all the little, you know, screenshots to be passing through, the Epicfail community is looking for a few members here within our G1 and G3 ranks here. So if you guys are looking for a new home, feel free to reach out to the people listed on the message above here. That's going to be the best way to get a hold of them. That's going to be on Discord. So if you guys don't have Discord, download it, get into it, because that's what a lot of the people out there, a lot of the guilds out there utilize as far as communication goes. So that's going to be it, guys. Thank you all so much for tuning in. It's your boy Childish, your Childish Place. Check it out. Take care, and we'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out.